R. Levesque Associates. They are offering landscape architecture, civil engineering, environmental permitting, and land surveying. RLA is a second-generation company devoted to excellence in the planning and design of outdoor spaces. On the web at rlaland.com or at 40 School Street in Westfield.
This is Ken Stomsky from Ken's Den on WCPC 15 and 89.5 FM, Tuesdays, 8 to 10.
Community Radio,
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield. There'll be no stinging half today. I forbid it. Or you can make it up.
You know, that is exactly what I need for the look for the second half of this program.
Okay.
That's ideal.
So we'll just leave it up for the whole thing.
Why not? Okay.
What mic are you on, Bob?
He's okay, on one. He's on
hello.
One.
Hello.
Okay.
There we are.
All right. So, Bob, the reason why you're seeing that today.
Yes.
Is because at 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
I'm going to have in Select Board Vice Chair Russ Fox and the town moderator of Southwick, Celeste St. Jack. And we're going to be talking about the articles in the warrant that are going to be at the annual town meeting in about a week or so. So actually, next week is the town election, and then the following week is the annual town meeting down there. And we're going to get into how the town government differs from our city government.
Yeah.
Here.
Well, I
know you've never heard of an article or a warrant before.
I thought they were going to arrest somebody.
Yeah.
The warrant.
Yeah.
I didn't know what
that
was.
So we're going to clear that up.
Oh, good. I can't wait.
So that is why the logo for my Southwick Channel 15 is down below today. And that's why we have the Southwick Town Hall in the background.
Is that your desk? Are we sitting at the Southwick desk?
No. They don't make me stay outside.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's about the view. That's about the view we had for the parade, though.
Yeah.
That's about where we set up for the parade.
Pretty much.
Yes. I love this. It's very nice. Very.
Yeah.
Nice.
So I think I don't have a studio down in Southwick yet. Pete and I both said that at the same time.
There was no studio in Southwick.
No.
There
really wasn't much of Channel 15 in Southwick.
Oh, well, gosh.
Because no one working Channel 15 Southwick in the past has come from something as big when it comes to community programming as this. We're getting there.
Good.
It might be a fabric green screen, but I'll have something down there. I want to thank Pete for accommodating me with the graphics on the.
Thank God for virtual sets.
Yeah. It's going to make a difference, and again, I don't have a studio in Southwick, and these folks are coming up from Southwick to Westfield to do a show about Southwick. So.
Speaking of shows about other things.
Yes.
You want to take a peek in the other room?
Before I get into something here, let's see what's going on.
Look at this.
And with audio, too. We can hear
this looks like a giant, this is some kind of cooking show.
It's going to be a cooking show, yes.
You like that? That mic's picking up pretty good, huh?
Yes. WTA Chef Showdown is being filmed over the next couple of days here.
Oh, it's a couple of dates thing?
Oh, it's going to take a few days to get this down, yeah.
Oh, I had no
idea. Yesterday was just a complete day of setup.
Yeah,
And we're still setting up.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so exciting.
Yeah, this is going to be a big deal.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a three-episode showdown. It's a team challenge, an individual challenge, and then a finale. It's going to be judged and everything.
Oh, it sounds so exciting. Mm-hmm. I love it.
Yeah, so needless to say, I was here all day yesterday, and I'm going to be here all day today, and I'm going to be here all day tomorrow.
Uh-huh.
But that's
good for you.
That's okay.
That's all right. And it's your job.
Yeah, and I know I have a WoW thing tonight, and if I appear tired when I'm at it, now you know why.
Well,
you saw what I'm involved with there.
Yeah, I mean, well, I will have been up since 5 a.m. at that time.
You're going to take a nap when you get home. Come on.
I got to go. No, I have to go. I have the dental cleaning.
Well, after that, you're going to go home and take a nap.
I'm going to probably fall asleep during the dentist's chair. I wonder if they can prop my mouth open and I can sleep.
Hey, Kenny, I think the teams are. Oh, look, we got Harry over there.
Look at that.
That's just
He's learning who everyone is.
We're going to take pictures. That's what we're doing. We're taking
pictures. Oh, yep. Okay, yeah. I see the phone in his hand.
We're taking pictures. Harry has to take his pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a Harry selfie picture?
How is he going to get in there as a selfie, though?
I don't know, but look at Harry's coaching him up.
Yep.
Yeah, Harry. Yeah,
he wants to be.
You can see him framing everyone.
Harry's coaching him up. This is funny.
Yeah. we don't have a mic yet in there.
And then we got Chef John and Chef John in the figuring out his blocking in the control room.
There's Chef John. He's not a judge. He's just your
he's our
man on the street, man in the
reporter.
Kitchen. Okay, got it. This is so exciting. They're going to make a filet mignon. And
that's the finale.
The finale, and they're a pork roast. And what's the other thing? Grilled cheese. Their own grilled cheese.
Challenge, yes. Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite go-to grilled cheese, Kenny?
Technically, it's not a grilled cheese. It's a melt.
Oh, it's a
melt. And I have to go with a patty melt or a tuna melt.
Oh,
but now you get into melts, and it's not a real grilled cheese. But, you know, grilled cheese, I would say a Gruyere and a Swiss. For the meltability.
Right. Right.
A slice of tomato.
Oh, man.
Some bacon.
Oh,
and, bacon. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes a pretty good.
Basil. Yeah. You know, I sort of like tomato and mozzarella and basil. It's close to a panini, right? Could a panini and a grilled cheese be the same?
If you take a grilled cheese and you make it fancy and you put it in a panini press instead of using a flat top.
Right.
Then sure, yeah.
Yeah. Would that be not, would that win any award at this thing?
It's up to them to figure that out.
Oh, okay. All right. I'm not
going right? to say that. You know, if they're cooking their grilled cheese and they want to say to themselves, hey, how do I want to prepare it? It's all up to them. There's no guidance. It's whatever they come up with.
I'll be back. You talk amongst yourselves.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. All right.
Good. I was just about to get into my monologue, but I can wait.
What was I going to ask you? I'm watching. I just happened to tune into there's a spring championship, bake championship on Food Network or whatever. And the one of the ingredients that they had to use was sauerkraut in a cake.
Why not? What I think I'm a little low compared to you. I grabbed the wrong chair again.
Yes, sauerkraut in a cake, Kenny. What would you do with sauerkraut in a cake? It just sounds so...
See that? I can look at you now.
Yeah, we're on the same level. Always. Okay.
All right.
Yeah.
Sauerkraut in a cake, huh?
Yeah, what are you going
to... Well, you know, a cake can be savory. It doesn't have to be sweet.
Yes, but sauerkraut?
Yeah, why not?
What would you? I know. Well, maybe you know. Now that I think about it, because I always put brown sugar in my sauerkraut, right? And caraway seeds.
Why not toss some kielbasa into that cake too?
Ooh, white cake or chocolate cake? You Polish people throw kielbasa into everything, don't you? I'm going to Wisconsin where we have brats.
Is it a brat or is it a brat?
I think it's a brat.
It's a brat. Because you say bratwurst or do you say bratwurst?
Bratwurst.
Bratwurst.
It's the W becomes a V. Bratwurst.
Uh-huh.
Yes. I love brats. Do you enjoy a brat?
It has to be one that's not too fatty. So where you when you bite into it, it just drips. You know, there are some commercial brats out there that are just horrible, and they're grief bombs.
I tried one of those plant-based brats recently.
Oh, I did too.
Ugh.
yeah, your people are the people pushing for all this non-meat meat.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I eat a lot of, no.
You're not going to see it. I'm going to see non-meat meat. I'm gonna see the world where you have a 3D printer and it prints out a T-bone on your counter.
Uh-huh.
All right, but I don't know if that's ever going to be the same.
I don't know. I have no idea. But I would say that I'm a pork. I enjoy pork, and I enjoy chicken. I don't have red meat often, but I do look forward to an occasional filet.
Right.
So I'm.
You're not going to get one down here this week.
Well,
that's what you're angling for.
Yeah, I was trying to angle. I like a nice taste. Well, but actually, Peter's responsible for the sirloin or what the
filet
mignon. Yeah, how many ounces are they cooking? Peter?
I bought 4 8-ounce portions.
Mmm, delicious. Oh, my God.
Look at this. It's 8:24, I'm assuming. On
go by that clock because I haven't got the graphics machine completely working.
Yeah, and I think I synced that clock up last week, so it's really close.
You did.
Okay, good. And it is the third day of May in the year 2022 Anno Domini.
May the 4th be with you.
It's not 4th yet.
It's not the 4th yet.
Oh, that's tomorrow.
Yeah.
But I'm saying it early because I'm not going to be here, and you're not going to be here. May the 4th be with you.
The views expressed by the host during his monologue are those solely of his own, not those of Westfield State University, the Radio Club, the Underwriters, or anybody down in culinary right now. That's all I got. Or people waiting in line for the horticulture plant sale. Mm. And now...
You know what, Pete?
What's going on, Kent?
You know what, Bob?
Well, yeah, what?
I went on a day road trip for the first time in over 30 years with my father this weekend.
Holy gosh. Oh, I got to hear about this.
Uh-oh. We were supposed to bring back a car he wanted to buy.
Uh-huh.
So let me start at the beginning. My father loves station wagons. You know, that's what we had when we were growing up.
Yeah.
Old Vista Cruisers, Crown Vic Country Squires. And when I moved out, he still loved wagons. Mm. And he bought a Buick Roadmaster wagon.
Ooh.
And that was 30 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
He has been on a quest for one for the past year or so now. These things came with a Corvette engine. All right?
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. All right. Now you understand the fascination.
Yeah.
Had an LS2, I think, in it.
Mm-hmm.
300 horsepower and a... 325 or whatever it was, and basically a 350 engine Chevy and a station wagon, you know, it's a sleeper. But he found one in New Hampshire, so we went up to get it. He was told the car needed nothing and was in perfect condition.
Mm.
Where did he find this?
Well, once we made...
Is this on Carvana? Or
no,
something?
No, personal thing. Once we made the 2.5-hour drive, we found out the seller lied. There were multiple major issues with it. Safe to say, if anyone within earshot of me has a Roadmaster station wagon they want to get rid of, reach out to me. You would think the story ends there, right?
Oh, yeah.
No.
How long a trip was it up there?
Well, naturally, I would have to drive him up, right?
Yeah.
And it's 2.5 hours. And I have no problem with driving him up, right? But my Caddy is 28 years old, and my Chevy only starts when it feels like it. And that's an $800 repair, so I'm going to let the Chevy stay that way.
Uh-huh.
He didn't want to bring his truck for that long, you know, listening to the exhaust of the Ram Air Hemi going down the highway.
Oh, sure.
Yep. So he would cover the cost of a rental. I would set all of that up, right? He did not want to ride in an economy car or some other small, quote-unquote, POS. Figure that out.
Piece of shite.
I told him I would look for a full-size sedan. As I was reserving the car, I kept scrolling through the options.
Yeah.
I decided that the Dadster was going to pay an extra $25 to bump up to a luxury sedan. And when I arrived to get the car,
yeah,
there was a problem with the license plate with the Chrysler 300S that I was supposed to get. They tried to put me into a high-end SUV, but the idea
Which
of...
I would have been thrilled about.
But the idea of getting a car was that it would be easier for my father to get in and out of and yeah, have a comfortable seat for hours.
Yeah.
Then they said, we have a Dodge Challenger.
Like what I had in Nashville.
I knew that the seat was going to be good, and the bigger door would make it easier to get in and out of. So I ended up getting that car and upgraded at no extra cost. When they pulled up, it was black on black, and it looked fast and aggressive. And I told the guy I was happy it wasn't red. Police magnet. I did also mention that with the New York tags on it, I will look like an arsehole. And he laughed.
I would laugh, too.
onto my father's house. I pull into the driveway. He walks out.
Yeah, what did you say?
And the first thing he says was, "You couldn't get it in red, huh?"
Oh!
Now you see where I get my train of thought and humor from.
Did he really say that?
Yes. The first thing's out of his mouth.
Yeah. No kidding.
Yeah. God's witness. Mm. So, knowing all this now, you can blame him for all the fart jokes on this program. He is a gearhead, and he has had his share of classic muscle cars and newer sports cars like Firebird Ram Airs.
Oh.
All right. I knew he was impressed with the car. Mm-hmm. After a while, as we were going down the road, he mentioned that I seemed comfortable driving it. And I told him that I can adapt to my situations easily. But he went on to say, the car suits you.
Ooh.
Now, I have
was he offering?
Nice.
Now, I have had sedans for over 20 years.
Yeah.
All right. My intent was to buy a Caddy sedan for my next vehicle. But this car grew on me.
It's a great car.
The acceleration, the handling. Oh, yeah, I tested it out. And the old man didn't flinch one iota. I love the sport mode.
Yeah, that was fun. On the highway opening, that sucker.
Yeah. You might be able to fit a pygmy in the back seat. You know, I kept my man purse in the back seat, and it was difficult just trying to get to it. I have no idea how anyone could climb into the back of this thing.
You can't.
There would be no hauling of speakers for gigs with this car, and I think I'm fine with that.
I don't know. The trunk was pretty big.
That's where the bodies go. This car made me feel younger. Now, I'm over 50, so I thought I had escaped having a midlife crisis, but now I don't know. These are selling new for $31,000. 9-year-old models are selling for $23,000 plus.
Yeah. Yep.
You know, I don't think I'm going to be getting one anytime soon.
No.
You know, I never paid more than $6,000 or $7,000 for a 6 or 7-year-old car in my life.
Until he goes to Vegas.
But now I really want one.
Until he goes to Vegas.
You see, this is a classic case of no good deed goes unpunished. Yes, I helped the old man out. Yes, I had a day of bonding with my father. Conversation took place throughout the drive. You know, I never really turned up the radio. But now I have the craving for a male midlife crisis sports car. Yes, my Caddy has a 295 horsepower North Star engine in it, and it is fast. But I can't drive a 28-year-old car like I stole it.
Oh.
I would hurt it. If any of you hit the lotto and I touched your life in any way, please remember me. Sitting at a light in my 05 Impala, making vroom vroom sounds with my mouth is no way to live.
Oh, my gosh.
That's where I was going to end it. I got a phone message last night at 9:30.
Yes.
Hey, I talked with that guy from New Hampshire, and he fixed the thing in the differential, and he fixed the engine light, and it looks like he's still honoring the price that I offered. So it looks like I'm getting the car. So now it's going to be another trip up.
God.
But I would still rather not sit at a light in my Impala going vroom vroom.
No.
True enough.
Let's pay our bills. We'll be back right after this.
My pappy said, son, you're going to drive me to drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln. Have you heard the story of the hot rod race with the Fords and Lincolns was setting the pace? That story is true, I'm here to say I was driving that Model A. It's got a Lincoln motor and it's really souped up. That Model A body makes it look like a pup's. Got 8 cylinders and uses them all. Got overdrive, just won't stall. With a 4-barrel carb and a dual exhaust, with 4 different gears you can really get lost. Got safety tubes, but I ain't scared. The brakes are good, tires fair. Pulled out of San Pedro late one night. The moon and the stars was shining bright. We was driving up Grapevine Hill, passing cars like they was standing still. sudden, in the wink of an eye, a Cadillac sedan passed us by and said, "Boys, it's a mark for me." By then, the taillight was all you could see. Now the fellas ribbed me for being behind, so I thought I'd make the Lincoln unwind. Took my foot off the gas, and man alive, I shoved it on down into overdrive. Wound it up to 110, my speedometer said that I hit top end. My foot was glued like lead to the floor, that's all there is, and there ain't no more. Now the boys all thought lost my sense, and telephone poles looked like a picket fence. They said, "Slow down, I see spots, the lines on the road just look like dots." Took a corner, sideswiped the truck, crossed my fingers just for luck. My fenders was clicking the guardrail post, the guy beside me was white as a ghost. Smoke was coming from out of the back when I started to gain on that Cadillac. Knew I could catch him, I thought I could pass. Don't you know by then we'd be low on gas. We had flames coming from out of the side. Feel the tension, man, what a ride. I said, "Look out, boys, I got a license to fly." And that caddy pulled over and let us by. Now all of a sudden she started knocking him down in the gym. She started to rock, and I looked in the mirror. Red light was blinking, the cops was after my hot rod Lincoln. They arrested me and they put me in jail, and they called my pappy to throw my bail. And he said, "Son, you're gonna drive me to drinking if you don't stop driving that hot rod Lincoln."
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Barnes and Noble College Bookstore in the Ely Campus Center, offering Westfield State t-shirts, sweatshirts, and gift merchandise, all of your academic needs, and offering textbook materials in new, used, ebook, and rental formats. Available at the bookstore on campus or online at westfieldstate.bncollege.com. Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Dunkin' Donut Shops of Westfield and the Sardinia family. It's nice to know that even as the world changes, Dunkin' Coffee remains the same at 7 convenient locations throughout Westfield.
Join us every Thursday morning
from 6 until at least 7:30.
Check out the Bobby G and Company Show
right here on WSKB 89.5.
Community Radio
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 at 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield.
Anal cleansing dates back to the Egyptians. Coffee enemas have been all the rage for a few years now. But at Rectify Holistic, we say, why stop at coffee? We have detoxifying all-natural enemas for every occasion. Get that minty fresh taste with a peppermint enema. Or be hydrated from behind with a coconut water enema. Acquire all the charm, hygiene, and je ne sais quoi of a Frenchman with a garlic enema. We've also got relaxing and inspiring flavors like Irish coffee, fruit juice, hamburger meat, or spicy ground turkey. Become nature's softy serve machine with an ice cream enema, or get ravaged by a burly Russian with the St. Petersburg surprise. Rectify Holistic. Come and get properly clean today.
With Mother's Day around the corner, let's get mom a gift. Remember, Rectify Holistic.
Do we really want to know what Rectify Holistic really is?
Oh, my God. I love it. I love it. I was looking at if it fits into any of the days today. Not a thing. It's National Raspberry Popover Day. Lumpy Rug Day. What else day is it?
Well, let's see what I have here.
What do you have?
In my Congressman Richie O'Neill
calendar. Oh, I gave
O'Neill
you this.
Calendar.
This is a gift from me to you.
Every day, there's a bit of history here.
Oh, right? Let's hear it.
So on this day, May 3rd, 1822, an act for the preservation and repair of the Cumberland Road passes the Senate in a 29-7 vote.
What year was that?
1822. Do you remember it? It should feel like
wow.
Almost yesterday.
I was one of the first people allowed on the Cumberland Road. It went through the Cumberland Gap where Daniel Boone and I used to hunt.
Mm-hmm. Is that where they built the first Cumberland Farms?
That's it was close to there.
Mm-hmm.
And we used to say, Dan, let's go over and see if we could get one of those frizzles It is a drink with ice, and they drizzled fruit juice into it, sort of like they called it a frizzle.
Oh, I thought you were confusing something with a fribble.
Yeah, oh, I thought so too.
Yeah, I thought he was going in that direction, Pete.
No, mm-hmm. It was a fribble. No,
not a fribble, a frizzle.
I said, Dan, you know, your hat isn't going to go places at all. You know, you got a ponytail on your. You got that that raccoon thing with the pony thing going. He used to wear his coonskin cap sort of side saddle. It was he wear the in front. It was pretty
like a graduation tassel.
Yes, it was sort of like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Dan Boone and I.
Yeah. Why is he remembered and you're not?
Well, I moved north. I should have stayed down there.
You asked him.
I don't know. Oh my God.
That's huge.
That's called going with the flow. Right.
And you know what? You're so good with going with the flow.
Yeah, what is it?
And you're all alone. You don't have Kathy this week.
Oh, I know. We should mention that she's not here.
It was going to be hard to fit her in the second hour of the program.
I gotcha. Yeah. Gotcha.
But you're still here.
Let me put my glasses
on. And now it's time for therapy with Bob Plass.
Hey, Bob, could you get the door?
Oh, thank. Well, Kathy's not here today, so I'm.
That's what I'm saying. Get the door.
Look, I'm gonna. I know who it is, and he's out there, and he wants to talk, and I just know it. I've had not a lot of sleep. I'm gonna go to the door. All right, I'll open the door and talk to him, but I'm charging him today. Hello, Ken.
Hi, Bob. I still have 3 freebie sessions, so I figure I'd come here and talk to you.
Ken, you've had 2 sessions.
Yeah.
Of the 3 freebie sessions.
Well, on the second one, we added additional.
Yes, but this is not one of those. Next week may be your freebie session. You come here next week and the week afterward. And
so you want the next 2 weeks free, but you want me to pay for today?
Yeah, I'm
going
to.
Is that what's going on?
That's exactly right.
What's your racket here?
Well, I'm going to be in Wisconsin.
Oh, Kathy's not here. You're going to cook the books.
I don't cook the books. I broil the books. It's a new method of you burn your books after you've cooked them.
Right.
You know, I like to serve my books with a nice, nice side salad.
What would be in that side salad?
Let's see. I think I would put it would be kind of it's an olive oil with a dash of lemon, some paprika, maybe a little jalapeno. I'm going to whiz in some mayonnaise. Because it's Cinco
de Mayo. Mayo what?
Yeah. Because it's Cinco de Mayo. Speaking of Cinco de Mayo, are you celebrating Cinco de Mayo? It's 2 days from now. May the 4th be with you tomorrow, incidentally. It's Star Wars Day.
You're hung up on that, aren't you?
Well, it's Star Wars Day.
He won't give it a rest. You can't let it go.
I mean, I can understand Kevin Grimsley being hung up on that, but not you, Bob.
I mean, maybe Thursday I will put a meme up on Facebook with a picture of a jar of Hellman's inside a kitchen sink. I may do that.
Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah.
Mm,
yeah. That might be as far as I push it.
Yeah. So, Ken,
why
are you paying me today?
I do have one of those. Margaritaville fancy schmancy blender drinking machines with the ice hopper on the top.
Oh man!
So maybe I'll make myself a slushy beverage.
How about a strawberry margarita? That's always my favorite. Or a basil margarita. Have you ever had a basil margarita?
A peach or a watermelon.
Cucumber margarita. Peach melon. What are you here for today? What are you paying me today for?
You know, I've been suffering the past. I've been suffering the past 3 weeks.
May the fourth be with you.
Because.
Yeah. Your teeth.
I lost the crown.
Yeah, I know you did.
And I finally got my full set of uppers in yesterday.
I cannot wait.
And.
Well, why aren't they in today,
my friend? I can't talk with them yet.
You can't talk? What do you mean?
You have to learn how mouth. To. You have to learn how to talk again. You have to retrain the muscles in your mouth. You know, it's like you don't have dentures yet, but you know when you get dentures put in now and then you have a plate under your tongue or at the top of your mouth and you have to learn how to talk again.
Oh,
and it's the same thing. And I just, it's going to take me hours wearing them at home before I can go out and actually have a conversation with them.
I see. So,
but I at least have them for Las Vegas.
Oh, it's lovely.
Yeah, and you can drink with them on. Well, so, you know.
Well, here's the deal.
You're all set.
I'm going to be all set in Vegas.
You could smile and not talk to anybody.
Exactly.
An actuality that fits in because you know what today is? Today is, it's actually the whole week from now until the 7th is Choose Privacy Week. You want to choose privacy because you're not able to talk with your mouth. So choose with your new teeth.
However, I'm not afraid to admit, during break, I did put them on so Bob could
You see looked it. Handsome as heck. You even smiled. I saw them.
But at the same time, unless I really did a big smile, you can't see them. So when I'm having a normal conversation normally you can't see my teeth anyway. You just see darkness.
Yes, true.
You know,
true.
All my life.
Until somebody makes you smile.
Yeah.
You smile often.
That's why I'm okay now not having them in because I can have this conversation with you and not really show off that you know, I have to wear, you know, a full set of uppers now.
Smile big and
but that's my problem. You ask me why I'm here.
Yeah,
I can't talk with the damn things on.
Well, this is the thing. You choose privacy. Then you never leave your house. You only go to Las Vegas. You wear a veil.
Wrong sex, Bob.
Well, no, men have veils. What do they call it when a man has a like a bee? You could go as a beekeeper to Las Vegas.
That's not a veil.
What is it? It's a kind of like,
that's a protective hood.
Wear your hazmat suit.
Yeah, suit.
Yeah, your hazmat suit to Las Vegas. But
the funny thing is, out on the strip, I probably wouldn't stand out.
You wouldn't stand out?
No, I wouldn't stand out with something like that on.
No, no one would say anything. Like, why are you wearing a hazmat suit on a hot day like today?
Although, you know what? That could be funny.
Yeah, what is
it? Something could be very... I could bring a hazmat suit to Vegas and go down on the strip.
Right.
And I could build a box and put a meter on it, you know, an analog meter.
Yeah.
And just slowly try to analyze the corner of a building of something, and I can have the box make sound effects, and I can just imagine the crowd of people forming around me while I'm screwing them with them that way.
Oh, I'll pay you for that.
That'd be an awesome
video
to make.
Yes, but then you're not choosing privacy, Ken. You're.
But I'd have.
You're
I'd be hiding in the hazmat suit, though.
Well, that's true, and then you could talk. And then you wouldn't have to show your beautiful new teeth.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas, if you choose, be bold. Go where no man has ever gone before.
I think that might be trademarked.
Well, yes, but yeah, you can go where no man has ever gone before.
And you know, Gene Roddenberry corrected that in the 80s.
What did he say? Go
boldly, go where no one has gone before.
Oh, they got rid of the man.
Yes.
Boldly go where no one has gone before.
Yes.
Go to the...
And instead of a 3-year mission or whatever, a 5-year mission,
yeah,
it was their continuing mission. Is to boldly go where no one has gone before.
So that they could have more episodes. That's why they're having a continuing mission.
Right. But now it's not exclusive just to men. Even though Uhura and... Actually, if you think back, the first racial kiss ever on television was Star Trek.
That's right.
Kirk not only kissed Uhura, but he also kissed that Orion woman too, the green woman.
Oh right, and didn't he give Didn't he give a nice little peck to George Takei? What was his name? Solo.
Sulu. What was George Takei? Yeah.
Sulu.
Yeah.
So why if the captain kissed Uhura? Were they going to continue a relationship or something, or was it just a...
I don't think Kirk was a relationship person.
Oh.
I think Kirk was a womanizer, to be honest.
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah, where that's why a lot of people might like Picard better, because he had a thing for Beverly Crusher.
Oh.
Right? Was that the doctor. He had a thing for the doctor, so he didn't really get involved, but... Kirk always seemed to hook up with someone in every episode, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we still had that element back then.
Yeah, yes, yeah.
But it was still a great TV show, and I'll still watch it. I won't be boycotting Star Trek.
But you don't care for Star Wars. When you ask,
I'm not a Star Wars person. I'm a Trek person.
Well, so tomorrow is the Star Wars day.
Well, you won't let this go, will you?
No.
Did you just find out that people are calling it May the 4th?
Yes.
Okay. That's why. I get it. You just figured it out.
I just figured it out. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. That's not new. That's been going on
for years.
For years. Yeah.
Oh,
May the 4th be with you for years.
Well, I was the 4th. Probably was I on with the radio last year on Tuesday? Wouldn't it last year have been?
I have no idea what day Tuesday would have been last year.
Well, is it one day ahead or one day behind?
Well, it also depends on if there's a leap year.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
Well, I think last year was leap year, if I'm not mistaken. So we might have skipped the day that I could have said to people, May the 4th be with you.
Yeah.
I'll text you that tomorrow on my way to Wisconsin.
Are you going to bring back cheese curds this time?
Didn't I bring them back last time? But I think I ate them on the plane on the way.
Yeah, you would.
Yeah, yeah. I will try to remember. I will try to remember that. And the folks are moving into my house. I got to clean my. Want to come over and clean the house for us?
No, I've been doing my spring deep cleaning the past week and a half.
Oh, God.
And it's taken me longer than usual because I'm actually working now.
I know you have a lot.
I've got things with KS Solutions. That I've got video projects I'm working on.
Got it.
Of course, things going on both in Westfield and Southwick. So
I don't know how you keep the city straight.
I still have a manual calendar that I print out and I write on. I have a written calendar
that says where you have to be at the right time.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
That and all the doctor trips I need to drive my father to. But
oh, sure.
You know that.
And you might be going up. You got to go up.
I've got to get in touch with him later on today to find out if I have to rent another car. And I'm going to rent another luxury car, and maybe I'll get stuck with that quote unquote stuck with that Challenger again.
You know, and then you could put in when your dad says to you, "You look pretty good behind that wheel." How about it, Dad?
Yeah. Don't you have a life insurance policy you can cash in?
Yeah. Really. Really. You could make me happy.
Yeah. Give me this car. Maybe it'll attract a lady friend, and
you
won't have to worry about me being alone all my life.
Yeah. That's exactly. See, you could come that, up with that.
That's a good angle.
That'll be $50, please. Leave your. The time is up here for this. That'll be $50. Leave it on the way out, sir.
Speaking of money,
yeah.
Something in the newspaper yesterday just made me disgusted.
Oh, no. Yeah. God, what is
it? Well, it looks like Lansdowne Place, downtown. You know,
I read that article.
Yeah, good. So they're going to have single bedroom, one bath, and two bedroom, two bath units that are just, you know, anyone can rent now. The students aren't
right.
staying at Lansdowne Place anymore.
Right, right. I heard that.
So, now, here we go. Downtown Westfield.
Yes.
All right. In a building, no yard, you're going to have to deal with an elevator or stairs to get back and forth. You might have room for one car down below.
Right.
Right?
Right. Do they have a sauna? Or
No, nothing like that.
Oh.
So the prices are going to start now.
One bedroom,
one bath. With under the conditions that I just said.
Right.
Will start at $1,400 a month.
$1,400.
$1,400 a month for one of those units.
To live in downtown Westfield.
Yeah, under those circumstances, under those conditions.
Well, I've got to do. Have they upgraded the apartments? I hope they've upgraded the apartments.
But still, I mean.
Well, you know, I mean, maybe there's
$1,400 to rent a one bed. I don't care if it's in a Taj Mahal. $1,400 to rent a one bedroom unit in Westfield.
It does sound like an awful lot of money. What are they usually going for?
Yeah, you know, I'm getting much less than that to rent a two bedroom.
You could get a house for that.
A two-bedroom unit and a two-family. I mean,
wouldn't you get a
with
house
a yard and off-street parking?
Well, maybe there's it's close to the bike trail. Maybe do they have a?
There's no
connection.
There's no interconnection there. No.
Oh, well, you're around the corner from us at Westfield Creative Arts.
Mm.
It doesn't come with anything there. But you could come around and say hello to me.
Yeah. I just want to say I was disgusted when I saw that $1,400 for a single. How does somebody now at this point, even with minimum wage $15,
yeah.
How does somebody on their own afford now a $1,400 single bedroom apartment?
I don't know. I have no idea. But I would want a view. You don't even have a window view of anything. I mean, you don't. Well, you have a view of the bike trail.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Ken. Were you planning on moving in there?
Absolutely not.
Oh. I know. You've got that lovely house over there.
And I'll be opening up the pool in a few weeks, too.
Oh, my gosh, yes. When is that happening?
When I get back from Vegas.
I hear it's going to be, I was looking at the weather in Wisconsin, and it is going to be 40s and 50s until the following week when it's going to be 70s.
Mm-hmm.
So we are approaching that 70-degree. And you know that one day it's 70, and then the next day after 70, it's like 95. And then I go, oh, my God.
That's what it is in Nevada right now. It's 90 right now.
Oh, man.
And I can't wait to get down there.
Oh, man. I don't know how you guys do it. I don't know how. Did you leave your $50 on the bureau?
Yes, please? I did.
All right. Thank you. I'll see you next week.
All right. I guess right about now, 8:58. I've got some important people coming in next. So I would say it's time for either you to go home and watch Regis and Kathy Lee or to go out and volunteer.
That's exactly right. And if you want to find anything that's happening in Westfield or many of the things. Oh, we got to mention Articulture is this weekend. So you can go to the Amelia Park Ice Arena and see Articulture. That's
right.
Artists and musicians and food and stuff at the and they've melted the ice so you can go on in the arena floor or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But good luck
this weekend.
Yeah, I'm not going to be able to go, unfortunately, but I really encourage everybody to do that.
I think I might be driving up to New Hampshire that day.
I heard. I can't wait. Oh, I cannot wait
again.
Now, when you get there, are you going to be angry if he hasn't fixed everything?
It's not me paying for the rental.
Oh,
I'll be neutral.
All right. Okay. Got it.
Yeah.
Thank you. Enjoy. Listen, happy Mother's Day. And Kenny, May the 4th.
You're going to
be with you.
Okay, Darth. Party on, Wayne. Party on, Darth. All right, Pete.
Ain't this? you want and more. Shop until you drop. Voodoo consumer, never stop. Load up on supplies. No sale, no compromise. Gun crazy down the mall. Voodoo consumer, take it all.
Eat this, drink this, try this, charge it. It's fabulous. Step right up and take it. Ridiculously cool, let's make it fabulous.
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 Drive me to the bank. Kneel down and give me thanks. Grab your credit card. Voodoo consumer, kiss me hard.
Eat this, drink this, drive this, charge it. Let's make it fabulous.
Too late, voodoo consumer terminate.
Eat this, drink this, try this, buy this, wear this, fly this, play this, charge it, it's fabulous.
Step right up and take it, it's fabulous. If you can't afford it, fake it. Be deviously dangerous, ridiculously marvelous, meticulously treacherous, disarduously cruel, just make it fabulous.
Support for Community Radio on WSKB is provided by Betts Plumbing and Heating Supply Company, an independent, family-owned wholesaler serving Westfield for over 50 years, specializing in plumbing, heating, and industrial piping supplies. On the web at BettsPlumbing.com or at 14 Coleman Avenue in Westfield. Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Dunkin' Donut Shops of Westfield and the Sardinia family. It's nice to know that even as the world changes, Dunkin' Coffee remains the same at 7 convenient locations throughout Westfield.
Join us every Thursday morning
from 6 until at least 7:30.
Check out the Bobby G and Company Show
right here on WSKB 89.5.
Community Radio
89.5. WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield.
And here we are. Don't you just love... what you see back here is a green screen, but if you take a look at the monitor here, this is what we're going to be sending out. So I hope having Town Hall in the background here makes it feel a little bit more at home. Ken Stomsky here, Ken's Den. Joining me today is Select Board Vice Chair Russ Fox and Town Moderator Celeste, and I never know if it's St. Jack or St. Jock's.
St. Jock.
St. Jock. Okay, good. All right, so... Everyone by now has figured out that I am working down in Southwick for their community access, their PEG access. And that means I get involved with their annual town meeting. And now, Carl Steinhardt, okay, the chief administrative officer for Southwick, all right, he schooled me on how a town government works in comparison to city government. And there were a lot of old term or old school words and terms used. For instance, where does the term select board come from? So now let's start with that. Russ, would you compare how a select board is to a city council?
All right. The town of Southwick operates under the purest form of government, an open town meeting form of government. The select board act as the chief officers of the town during the year, but it is up to the voters at any special or annual town meeting to set the rules. They're the ones that approve the budgets. They're the ones that approve all contracts. They're the ones that approve all bylaws, everything that is done at a town meeting. So that is different from, let's say, our wonderful sister city of Westfield, where they have a mayor and a city council. The city council basically acts as the public does in Southwick, and then the mayor is the chief elected official.
Mm-hmm. Great. And for you, Celeste, what does a town moderator do?
So the town moderator...
And I'm going to have you either come closer to the mic or get the mic closer to you.
So the town moderator will read the articles that are on the warrant and will filter questions. So when the public comes up and speaks, they will address the questions or comments to the moderator. One interesting thing to add to what Russ said about the open town meeting is it's rumored that the open town meeting actually dates back to the Mayflower, and the first annual town meeting, open town meeting, was actually held on the Mayflower.
That's incredible. So you did mention warrants. Now, explain articles and warrants, because in city government, we have an agenda, and we have items on an agenda when we're going to have a meeting. So how do articles and warrants come into play here?
Well, a warrant is developed, which contains all the articles of all the doings at a special or annual town meeting. Once that's approved by the select board, that would go to the constables, which are in charge of posting it in several public locations, i.e. town hall, our post office, schools, things of that nature. And this is to announce that we are going to be having a town meeting.
Mm-hmm. And so that's the warrant. What's an article now?
The articles are individual items that are brought before the citizens of the town of Southwick for them to review and to approve. Some are to do with money articles. Some are to do with bylaw articles, zoning articles. But it's basically like a motion.
So it's sounding like a line item on an agenda.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Good. I know that I've caught on to it, and I've learned town government since I've started working for you folks in August. But some of my listeners may just be curious and go, you know, how do they work, you know, in that little town to the south, which isn't really a little town anymore. What's your 11,000 plus?
No, we still haven't cracked 10,000.
Oh, okay.
but the town has grown. Mm-hmm. When I grew up in Southwick, and I remember when it was only a few thousand people.
Uh-huh.
So Southwick over the years has been very desirable for people to move there. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of Westfield residents that have moved to Southwick.
Mm-hmm.
We've had Connecticut residents that moved to Southwick across the border. So, you know, it's a beautiful recreational and rural agricultural community. And we have a lot to offer for a small community, and I think it's very desirable. Oh, we got a beautiful Congamon Lakes, you know, almost 500 acres. We have our rail trails. We have, of course, motocross. We have the Motocross National in July this year. The Rugged Maniac is always a big thing in September. But the, one of our hidden jewels right now is the rail trail, which connects with Westfield and goes down into Connecticut. And the activity on our rail trails grows each year.
And that trail in Southwick is completely level the entire way through, isn't it?
Basically.
Yeah. All right. Because that's important for some of us.
I rode the bike trail just down Simsbury up through Westfield, and it's pretty flat.
Yeah.
You can get a pretty decent workout, though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you've got to remember that used to be a railroad.
Yeah.
And the railroad in
you
South...
You can't have huge inclines on a rail system.
And the railroad was abandoned. I remember as a kid the bus having to stop for the train passing on Feeding Hills Road or going under the underpass on Depot Street. Of course, where the depot used to be.
I might be aging myself, but I remember when the trains used to run the track going through downtown Westfield to get to H.B. Smith.
Yep, that's true. That's true. Yeah. I do remember that also.
Yeah.
And I'm newer to Southwick, so I don't... I'm a native Rhode Islander who just kind of transplanted since my husband was from the area, so I don't know any of this. But, you know, similar small town, similar stories.
Now, at the annual town meeting, I'm just... curious, Celeste, how is the voting done?
So the voting actually is done. We ask for yays and nays.
Mm-hmm.
All in favor say aye, all in favor say nay. If we question a vote, if we're not sure on the count, then we go to a hand count.
Mm-hmm.
And if we feel like we need to, we can go to a paper.
Okay.
Paper ballot. Mm-hmm. So, you know, depending, some of the articles on the warrant require a 2/3 majority, some are simple majority, some are 4/5. Mm-hmm. So we go by that. We set the number. You know, and it's great to get so many people involved. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm looking forward to having some new members. I'm looking actually forward to having my 18-year-old come out with some of her high school seniors. They're kind of getting interested. Since we talk about it in our house, some of her friends are really interested in seeing what it's all about. So it's good to get those kids involved so they can become active citizens.
Great. So I know that you want to mention how an annual town meeting works, how you should act at one, how the process goes. And I know that you wanted to hold off towards the end to talk about that.
We can do it however you want.
Well, let's make sure we have room for that at the end, but let's jump right into the articles. That's why you're here.
Okay. All right. Our town meeting follows our annual election. The annual election is the second Tuesday in May. Our annual town meeting is the third Tuesday in May.
Mm-hmm.
And that came about, we've had town meetings in March, we've had them on Saturdays, we've had town meetings in April, you know, in elections in April. This all changed when Southwick regionalized our school system. And we had to push back our elections and push back our town meeting to May. So.
Gotcha.
People say, well, they're not sure when the election is or when the town meeting is. It's always the second Tuesday in May that you vote for your annual election. And it's always the third Tuesday in May that you have your annual town meeting. I will say there was an exception during the pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
We had to extend it, and we did it in June. I think that was 2 years ago. So it can, under an emergency, be changed to a different day.
Okay.
But the elections have to take place on that second Tuesday in May.
Mm-hmm. So before we actually get into each of the articles, I am going to mention for folks watching it now or for folks that might catch it in reruns, I'm going to be taking this section and clipping it out. I'm going to be posting it on the Southwick Channel 15 YouTube page. I'm going to put a link on the Facebook page for community programming in Southwick. I'm going to put a schedule that it's going to be run on Channel 15 in Southwick. And that schedule I'm going to post to the bulletin board on Channel 15. And if you're not a Comcast subscriber, you can still watch Channel 15 in Southwick. You just go to the Town of Southwick webpage, to the Channel 15 department, and there's an area on there. You click on it, you watch Southwick TV, and you can watch a live stream 24 hours of whatever we have going on that channel. So there's always going to be a way to watch this.
Excellent. Yeah, I think the more that we get out about Channel 15, because there's still people that aren't aware of it, I encourage people to go to it. They talk about they're not aware of certain events going on in Southwick. Channel 15 is a great source. The town crier in the center of town that we put up helps. There's even signs, changeable sign at the transfer facility. Mm-hmm. So we try to get the message out, and we strongly encourage people to sign up for Code Red with their cell phones or their landlines so that they can get emergency notices. We also, every year, notify the residents by Code Red, which used to be called Connect City, of the special town meeting and the annual town meeting and the election. Mm-hmm. So people are we tried to do our best along with the local news media publicizing all these events.
Great. We have 45 minutes to do everything that we need to do. Is that going to be enough time?
I think that is plenty of time.
Okay.
And all right. Normally, at the annual town meeting, we have a special town meeting prior to it. This year, our special town meeting will begin at 6 p.m. on May 17th. The purpose of the special town meeting is to clean up all the items of fiscal 22, okay? Mm-hmm. That's the fiscal period we're in now. We have to clean this all up before we go into the new fiscal period that begins July 1st, fiscal 23. So, Article 1 is a transfer of existing funds that covers negotiated agreements for staff for a total of 50-plus employees in the present fiscal year. These funds come from several salary reserve accounts and available funds set aside to cover these costs. Funds also cover backfill expenses for people out on the job due to injuries and sickness, as well as existing services for COVID-19 responses. The total of this article is going to be $107,705. And this is an annual thing, again, to clean up the items for the current fiscal period.
Mm-hmm.
Article 2 is the article, the town experiences snow and icing events beyond what was budgeted, some which require overtime and the use of outside hired vendors, the cost of road salt to treat roads, contribute heavily to these expenses. This will allow the town to close out its books in balance with snow and ice deficit as of June 30th. Otherwise, the deficit would be added to next fall's tax bill. Funds are covered. Funds to cover Pandemic CARES Act costs deemed ineligible and replenish unemployment accounts. Ice and snow is one of the few things where we can deficit spend legally.
Same here.
Okay?
Yep.
And that's the same in every municipality.
Yep.
And then you clean it up at the end of the year because no one knows when it's going to snow or ice or how bad or how good. This year was a moderate year, but we still deficit spend. But we are going to replenish our salt at this time. We have a beautiful new salt shed where we got a grant fund for a few years back. So we're going to buy our salt now for next year at a cost savings because we're taking the salt early. Mm-hmm. So this is certainly benefits the taxpayers of the town of Southwick. Article 3 is this article allows us to make our annual deposit to other post-employment benefits.
OPEB.
OPEB. That's been in the news quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
A trust fund established at town meeting years ago. The town currently pays for post-employment health care expenses on a pay-as-you-go basis. This type of fund, which was authorized by the state, provides a tool for municipalities to recognize the liability and begin to cover costs. Eventually, this fund will hold several hundred thousand dollars to cover health costs, annually contributing to is recommended by our independent auditors and is looked upon favorably by bond agencies. And that's a big deal. That's a very big deal. Like I said, I believe it's the city of Springfield and other communities. I think Springfield's considering a bonding issue of $26 million to cover some of their OPED, you know, and pay for that bond over several years.
Yeah, you never know when a high rating for bonds might come in handy.
Right. Southwick has a very good bond rating. And one of the reasons why is because we have established this. Matter of fact, we're going to be modifying this later on at the town meeting. But it certainly, it's another thing that benefits the taxpayers of the town of Southwick.
Mm-hmm.
Article 4, and this is where we're very fortunate. We have some extra free cash this year. Because of we were able to collect back due taxes from an entity in town that went through a rough period.
Okay, yep.
And now they're back with a new management, new owners, and they again are going to become once again an asset to the town of Southwick. Mm-hmm. So we have this along with some other monies we were able to collect because of back taxes. So we decided to use this money under Article 4 to purchase some capital items that we feel, because of the pandemic, there's a delay. One of the items that we're looking for is a DPW road machinery tractor with mower attachments. Fire department is looking for a new ambulance because our brand new ambulance was hit and destroyed in an accident. We have a fire department pickup truck that we need to add and a fire department vehicle utility box, which will go on that truck. And also we're looking to replace our police department patrol boat. And the reason why we're asking the voters to approve this using free cash is because of the pandemic, everything's delayed.
Right.
It's taking more time to order anything.
I don't think you can get an F-150 or an F-350 right now.
Correct.
Yep.
So these are, by doing it at the special, we can immediately order these. If they're approved by the voters, we can order these items. Rather than waiting till July 1st when the new fiscal period begins.
Gotcha.
So it gives us a few extra weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So, and the last article for the special is Article 5, and these are funds approved to secure vendors soon to undertake paving operations throughout town. Those funds will be supplemented by ARPA, which is the American Rescue Plan Act, federal funds to address road infrastructure needs. Southwick, like every other community, is behind because of the type of winters we've been having. Asphalt isn't the same material it was 30 years ago.
No.
Roads are falling apart, bridges, culverts. Obviously, the Chapter 90 money that we get is not sufficient to address all the needs in Southwick or any other community. So we're fortunate that we have this free cash, and we have some money left over from ARPA that we can address additional roads.
Good.
And I should quickly add that last night at our regular select board meeting, we also found out that we'll be getting some additional funds for infrastructure from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, along with every other state. So that's positive news. So between the Chapter 90 money, the money that we received, are told that we were going to receive last night, and if the voters approve this article, mm-hmm. we're going to be able to tackle more roads this year.
That's right. We're supposed to see a little bit more with Chapter 90, right?
That's
still a thing?
That's the hope. Each year, the Mass Municipal Association encourages the legislature and governor to give municipalities more Chapter 90 monies. So far, that hasn't happened. It seems a little ridiculous.
Well, you know, that 200 million or is it 200 or 300 million that they set aside for Chapter 90 at the state level, that number was come up with 10 years ago prior to the costs of everything going up.
Right. I mean, with inflation at a 40-year high, I mean, it's costing over $1 million to do a mile road.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not sufficient. I don't understand, you know, of course, I'm getting political now.
Yeah, you have the going wage rate when it comes to any type of that road work, too.
Right, it's prevailing wage.
Yeah.
And, but, you know, again, don't mean to get political, but if we have billions of dollars in surplus in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts,
mm-hmm.
let's repair the roads. Let's repair the roads.
I know many people who are with you on that.
Totally agree.
Yeah.
Moving along to the annual town meeting, which mm-hmm. begins at 6:30 p.m. So you'll notice there's only a half hour for the special. Mm-hmm. So the moderator moves the meeting right along. You know, we're asking people to get there before 6 so they're in their seats because we are beginning right at 6.
We'll begin very promptly at 6.
And we're going to move right along. And we're not saying people shouldn't ask questions. If you have questions or concerns, ask them. Feel free to ask them. We have the answers, but we're moving right along.
My automation is set to go right at 6 o'clock.
Right. Yeah. So 6:30, we're going right to mm-hmm. the annual town meeting.
Right.
And I don't know if you want to mention where the annual town meeting is going to be this year.
The annual town meeting is in the high school auditorium. This is the first year we're inside. Last 2 years we were outside. My first town meeting was done on the back of a pickup truck. And not a problem. I actually love that pickup truck, but we'll be inside this year. In the auditorium, there'll be a space set mask area. If people want to wear masks, masks are optional, but there will be a place set up for people who just want to wear masks and want to be around people wearing masks.
Beautiful.
So feel comfortable. We want everyone to be as safe as possible and feel comfortable coming.
Okay. I'm going to do the first... Probably 5 articles are what we refer to housekeeping articles. These are the same articles you see every year. Basically, the first article 1 is just telling everybody that we had a town election and who ran or what positions. Article 2 is town reports. That people accept the town report that they receive. If they go to vote, there's a town report they can pick up. Or they can pick it up at town hall, or there will be some copies available at the town meeting.
It also will be posted on the town website,
right.
Probably this week.
Right. And Article 3 is to appoint minor officers. Again, the select board operates as the chief executive officers for the town of Southwick during the year.
Mm-hmm.
So this allows us to appoint minor officers. Article 4 is to sell or trade obsolete equipment. Again, this is something that we do every year when we have pieces of equipment that are no longer serviceable, that we get rid of them. In Article 5, it gives the authority to the select board to apply and accept grants. The town of Southwick has been very fortunate. We've received numerous grants for our fire department, police department. In the past, we've received millions of dollars, for example, to purchase North Pond, to preserve that in perpetuity. So we work very hard. We apply for a lot of grants. We've been very successful.
Mm-hmm.
And so the first 5 articles, again, we call them our housekeeping articles. A lot of time, the moderator, at her discretion, will ask people to vote on all 5 at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
So that speeds mm-hmm. up the meeting.
Mm-hmm. And if there is any objections to that, we can pull one out. But we haven't had any issues with that for the past few years. So, but you definitely can't ask for something taken out or ask questions regarding those.
Okay. Article 6, this is the article requesting a bonding to repair the roof at Town Hall, former Consolidated School. Unfortunately, the Community Preservation Committee, the majority on a 5-4 vote, voted not to use community preservation funds to preserve this historical building, even though the Historical Commission was behind it and said it was legal, and it certainly was legal to use those funds. But they chose not to, and they're a recommending board. And
they're the stewards of that account.
Right, right. So we will be bonding for this. Plus, we will also be addressing our aged vac and really fixing something that should have been fixed 25 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Ever since we remodeled Consolidated School and made it our town hall, our senior center, a building that gets activity 7 days a week. It's a beautiful building. I went to school there. I think all my brothers did. Mm-hmm. My father was part of the first graduating class back in 1928, 29, something like that. So it's going to be, I'm looking for it's $2,663,259. Now, that's what we're going to be requesting on the article to bond it. We do think that we're going to be able to have some offsetting funds, but we have to bond for the entire amount.
Exactly.
Okay? Because that's something written by bond counsel. The wording is specific for that article.
Mm-hmm.
But we're hoping to use some offsetting funds, some savings from the fire department roof account that we finished up. Article 7 is, again, we're back to OPED, okay? And this is an article to basically updates our OPED. The Massachusetts Department of Revenue is requesting communities to readopt a newer version of Mass General Law 32B, Section 20. This is to ensure that OPED, other post-employment benefits, trust fund can be used for any other cannot be used for any other purpose. It will also allow for accounts to accept grants and gifts. The other vote is to ensure OPED trust and fund investments follow state guidelines. So the state has looked at communities that set up OPEDs, you know, and set up accounts, and now they want to clean up the language to make sure that nobody can take those funds for any other purpose. And they also want to make it so if we have grants or gifts that can be put into that
mm-hmm.
OPED fund. Article 8 goes along with that. That's Article 7 and Article 8 are dealing with the OPED. Article 9 is our annual budget. And this is where we go over line item by line item. This is something a city council would do, go over their budget line item by line item. But this is where the citizens of the town of Southwick that attend the annual town meeting, we go over every single budget line item by line item.
Mm-hmm.
And they can ask any questions, express any concerns, when we go over the budget. So it takes a little while to do that. There's a lot of information. The finance committee becomes involved at this point. The finance committee makes the recommendations. The finance committee works with the select board to come together with a budget. We have come together and we're unified in presenting this budget this year.
Mm-hmm.
So Article 10 is another housekeeping article. It sets up the revolving accounts. Now, revolving accounts are for different things, such as the inspectors, building inspectors, boat ramp, police chief lake, lake management, council on aging. It's where people collect fees or donations into a specific account. It's limited. For example, the building inspector for the inspections is limited to $40,000. So it allows them to collect those monies and use those monies in the current fiscal period for unforeseen things. So it's a good way of keeping that money off the taxed rate. Mm-hmm. You know, these are offsetting revenues.
Mm-hmm. So, and just to keep you on time, we have 25 minutes.
Okay. Yep. In other words, speed it up.
Whatever you need to do to make it happen.
Okay.
Just telling you what I have on the clock.
Okay. Moving right along. Article 11, we go into the community preservation. Now, they have probably three articles. Basically, one is their annual budget, which we do every year. One is to set, Article 12 sets their administrative expenses. All right, that's for their secretarial, anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have an Article 13, and this was a applicant that went in front of the Preservation Committee, and they voted to recommend it to the voters. It's a little unusual. It's from a private for-profit entity that needs to correct some issues concerning the Americans for Disabilities Act on the property. And it's a sum of $28,000. And again, it's a little unusual because normally community preservation funds are tax dollars, and they usually go to either town things like Wally Park, establishing Wally Park, or recreational activities, the track at the regional school, or they go to nonprofits such as the Historical Society for their museum. So this is a little different. Last year there was a request from another for-profit entity. It did not pass.
Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of discussion about tax dollars going to private entities.
Right.
But it's up to the voters to decide. Article 14 is also community preservation. We have a 10-year bond, approximately a 10-year bond on the alum treatment for the lakes that was approved. This would be a payment of that bond, and that'll be a payment or an article people will see for the next 10 years. Article 15 is the budget of the town regional school system.
Mm-hmm.
And what's different about this is it is not line item by line item. The school district just presents a budget for $12,252 and $252,012. Their budget hearings are held prior to the annual town meeting.
Same here.
Right. So school committee basically does their line by line item. They have their hearings.
Mm-hmm.
They do meet with the finance committee and the select board. They do meet with the other two communities that are part of our region. Southwick does pay between 84 and 86% of the budget. So it's tough to ask questions, but you can ask questions.
Mm-hmm.
Excuse me. So it's funny that we'll spend like an hour on the town budget and spend about 2 minutes on the school budget.
Yeah.
And the school budget is over 50% of the entire budget. But
I get it.
Article 16 authorizes the regional school budget debt, and that's basically what they're bonding for. This year they're looking at repaving the student parking.
Mm-hmm.
At the back of Southwick Regional. Let's see. Article 17, this is a little confusing. This was an issue that came about by a private individual on White Street. White Street is a non-accepted, it's a private way. And what this individual asked for, and he worked with an attorney, worked with the state, worked with the abutters, wanted to change the pathway of the right-of-way. White Street is a very narrow street that goes down by Congammon Lake.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So this gentleman went out. He worked with everybody. And basically, if the voters approve this, it really doesn't affect the town. The town still will be able to go down there, do snow removal, ice, take care of water, sewer, if ever, you know, gets down there, mm-hmm. things of that nature. So it's not an issue. But if we don't approve this, it becomes a even more costly legal cost to the town of Southwick, because then the Commonwealth of Massachusetts will be involved. So it makes it more difficult. Mm-hmm. So again, it's a little difficult to explain. Probably I'm going to suggest the lawyer explain it at town meeting. Mm-hmm. But if the select board's going to be recommending it. You know, we've reviewed this. It's really something making a mountain out of a molehill.
Gotcha. So,
but Article 18 is something that we've been working on, and it's a hawkers and peddlers article. What it does is set some regulations to times when people can be soliciting mm-hmm. or selling in the town of Southwick. It also sets up a method for the police department to do some checks on who is doing it, fingerprints, things like that. So it's something that the select board is supporting along with the Southwick Police Department to make our community safer. Mm-hmm. All right, we're getting to the end, but now we got two more difficult articles.
Is number 19 one of the biggies?
Number 19 and number 20 are articles submitted by the planning board. Mm-hmm. Article 19 is 6 pages long. I suggest to people, if you have an interest in this, you review it prior to the town meeting. Mm-hmm. Article 20 is 10 pages long. There is a lot of legal language in this. I've read these both over probably a dozen times. I met with the town planner last night because to prepare to come here today to try to, what can we do to kind of dumb this down to people so that they can make an intelligent vote.
There's a lot here to dumb down.
There absolutely is. You know?
There's an awful lot here.
Right. And I'm not saying whether they're good or bad. I'm just saying... you know, I think there's a lot of good in both of these, but that's my opinion. Article 19 is basically would address a major development coming to the town of Southwick. In essence, what it would require is any business that met a certain threshold, a certain size, would go to the town planner, say that we are interested in coming to the town of Southwick. This is what we envision. He would make the determination if this zoning bylaw was passed that they would be required to do approximately a month's worth of work prior to meeting with the planning board by submitting all documentations, as much information as possible, holding public meetings. It's not. I mean, a lot of this information they'd have to present to the planning board eventually.
Yeah.
But it requires them to kind of do this first and slows down the process.
All right.
In other words, if somebody came to town, they'd apply for a special permit and needed to apply for a special permit. They'd apply for a special permit with the town clerk. The clock starts ticking. The planning board has X number of days to address it, hold public hearings, mm-hmm. get the information, and address it. With this, that clock wouldn't start ticking until the town planner is satisfied and gives the information to the planning board and says that this is an acceptable application at this point.
Gotcha.
Then the clock would start ticking. Mm-hmm. Again, I think there's some good things in here. You know, having been on economic development for 10 years and worked to get Wally Computer to stay in town, get B&E Tool and DNS to stay in town, We were very fortunate to get Westfield Gauge to come to Southwick. Mm-hmm. From an economic development standpoint, you want to try to make sure that people know that you're business friendly. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying every business is going to be acceptable to the town of Southwick, but I think you want to at least have that handshake at the beginning and welcome people.
Do you have a tax shift in Southwick?
We've negotiated TIF agreements.
Is okay.
Wait a minute. Are you talking about TIF agreements or different tax rates?
Different tax rates.
No.
Okay.
Like most small communities, we have a residential factor of one. We only have one tax rate.
Okay.
And as being an assessor for 10 years, I can tell you that that's the norm in most small towns.
Okay.
So a lot of people don't understand that. Mm-hmm. But Southwick being small, we don't have enough commercial or industrial.
Well, that's the thing. You know,
we'd have to increase their tax 50-60%, and then they'd leave the town of Southwick.
We're in Westfield, we're looking to pull businesses in for that tax base.
Right, right. Well, every community is.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't understand why some people don't understand this. You know, I grew up in Southwick. I'm a farmer. Mm-hmm. I want to protect the rural character of the town of Southwick. My family preserved our farm through the Agricultural Preservation Act. We made that decision because we wanted to see that farm always preserved and farmed in perpetuity. And there's other farmers that have done the same thing. So, you know, I have great love for my community. I want to see that, stay that way. Mm-hmm. But a community, one that's growing like Southwick, has to have a balance. It has to have residential, has to have commercial. It has to have some industrial. And I'm not talking about smokestacks and large factories.
Right.
We have an industrial park. Mm-hmm. We have land that's zoned industrial. Our people years ago set aside this land that this would be the industrial park for the town of Southwick.
Okay.
Okay? So, and I know there's strong feelings. Something that got way out of control. I think there was a lot of misinformation, a lot of accusations, a lot of things said. But Southwick is a beautiful community. It's growing. I think we all agree we want to keep it that agricultural community, that rural community. We offer a lot of activities. But we can also put people in our industrial areas. And I think that we have a planning board that's five elected individuals.
Right.
Five elected individuals by the voters. Mm-hmm. I think they have the good common sense to make good decisions for the town of Southwick. All right, so Article 19, again, would be an issue addressing major development, okay? Mm-hmm. And the planning board worked on this. They modified it. They're going to be recommending it.
Mm-hmm.
Article 20 is to address basically cell towers.
Right.
Okay? We're in litigation right now, the planning board and Verizon, over a cell tower placement in the Lexington Patriot area.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That area was in an area that was deemed permissible to put up a cell tower. So Verizon put in an application for a cell tower.
Mm-hmm.
There's other areas that in town listed. But you got to remember, this was something done in 1996 when I think fewer than 3% of the people had cell phones. Now we're at a different point in time where just about everybody has a cell phone. You're using it for personal use, you're using it for business. So what the planning board is envisioning and what they're recommending is that we basically look at all areas in the town of Southwick for not just cell towers, but now you have different technology.
5G.
Right. You have things being placed on the top of telephone poles now,
mm-hmm.
rather than these huge cell towers. So what they're saying is, let's relook at technology, how it's changing, enact this new zoning bylaw, And if Article 20 is approved, Article 21, the last article, is to do away with our overlays on cell towers.
Okay.
So, in other words, we would be giving more discretion to our planning board and to our town planner so that if an application came in, they could look at it. Is this a better location? Is this good? There still would be hearings. There still would be opportunity for everybody to speak up. Okay? Mm-hmm. Nobody's denying that. Public still has their rights. Everybody still has their right of appeal. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah, you're still going to have a balloon flown so people can correct. See where it would
correct.
Look.
Correct.
Yeah.
This is just trying to look at technology as it exists today
mm-hmm.
and how it might change in the future.
So, gotcha.
So that, Ken, is basically we have the 5 or 6 articles at the special. We have 21 articles at the annual. The first 5 are housekeeping. So, and like I said, the school budget is... They present it. It's usually
I get it. Here we say yes or no. We can't change anything on it.
Right. Yeah. It's if you vote it down, then all the towns have to meet again.
Mm-hmm.
If 2 of the towns agree with the budget, then it's approved. The only thing we're all 3 have to approve is with the bonding for that $200,000.
Mm-hmm.
That would be the only thing. Yeah, you can't do any bonding unless all 3 communities agree to it. So, and again, people have had an opportunity to go to the school meetings, had an opportunity to go to the hearings. You have the majority of members on the regional school committee are Southwick residents, again, because we pay 84% to 86% of the budget. So we do have the majority vote.
And to find out about any of these meetings, you can go to the town website. You know, southwickma.com. There's 2 of them. there's net and org.
.org.
.org. The email's net.
I'm
still getting used to that.
I used to have to look it up.
But southwickma.org. Yeah, southwickma.org. And you drop down to the bottom on the right-hand side, and you'll see a calendar there, and it'll highlight every meeting that's happening.
Great. I mean, people could check that on a daily basis, make it part of your life, you know. I don't know how many times people have come up to, we didn't know about this, we didn't know about that. People aren't reading newspapers anymore.
I bring that up because that's been an issue up here with 40,000 people.
It's also great to listen to the recorded meetings are also on the website, which is a great way sometimes if you can't actually get to a meeting but you want to hear what's happening. Listen to a recorded meeting on your way home from work.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of meetings, how are we to act at an annual town meeting? What is the process?
Okay.
When we show up to the high school, what is expected?
Well, so first you're going to check in with our town clerk, Michelle Hill, and her staff. And they'll, you know, check every registered voter in the town of Southwick is eligible to come and vote.
Need an ID?
No.
We don't have voter ID right now.
Okay.
But, you know, you never know what the future holds. Okay, so you come to the town meeting, you take your seat, you turn your cell phone off. If you do need to use your cell phone during the meeting, we ask that you walk into the hallway. And it, not only if you walk in the hallway, you walk down the hall, because I guess the noise, from what I've heard, the noise can't echo. Mm-hmm. But you're going to take your seat, and we're going to start the meeting, and as a voting member, you're allowed to come up and make a comment, ask a question, make a comment on the article. All questions and comments have to do with the article that we're discussing. You can't, like if we're appropriating one of our articles that has to do from the CPC, you want to comment on that one. Like when we talk about the budget, we're going to vote on each individual budget and then move on from that. So all your comments are and questions are directed towards the moderator and have to pertain to the article we're speaking at.
Mm-hmm.
You have 2 minutes to speak. Questions, comments, really try to stick to this. I try to keep a timer. It's a little bit hard sometimes when people are talking, a lot going on, so kind of just, you know, if you go over or under a little bit, that's fine, but let's just try to keep it, let's keep it civil. We're not here to question, to attack others. We're here to really take care of the articles and address the individual articles. We do have some bylaws in our town code book that you can read online. We follow town meeting time, which is what all moderators that are moderating town meetings follow. There's also online a citizen's guide to the town meeting that you can look up. We're setting up our microphones a little bit different. We typically have had students run around to everyone who wants to talk. We'll be setting up two microphones on each side of the auditorium, and people can come down and make their comments. Unless, of course, you're handicapped and you need to, please raise your hand. Another important thing to remember is if you disagree with how we call a vote, like I'll call it the vote passes if the vote fails, if you question it, you can stand up and scream point of order. Question the moderator, because once we move on from that and move on to a next one, it's too late. So speak up right away if you don't agree with the way a vote is called. And that's basically it. It's just we really want to keep things moving along. We want to give as many people an opportunity to talk, as many people to ask questions. If you're standing in line and you have a question and the person in front of you asked and answered, let's move on. Mm-hmm. Let's keep it civil.
Now, speaking of the questions and public commenting, this is strictly just a comment. There's no debate or anything going back and forth
here. But you can ask questions. Like I know like some people will ask questions to our DPW director, Randy Brown, on roads, or why they'll ask the fire department, why do we need a new truck? They'll ask the police chief, can you explain to us why we need a new boat?
Mm-hmm.
And this is the time that they can explain, you know, this is their opportunity to say, well, we need a new boat because I think our boat is about 35 years old. So, you know, he'll be able to explain that and why we need something. So there is opportunity for questions.
Mm-hmm. But I think you, to go to your question, Ken, yes, you can get up there and say, I don't agree with this, mm-hmm. and this
Absolutely.
Is the reason why, mm-hmm. and I will be voting against it,
mm-hmm.
or I will be voting, or you can speak in favor of it,
mm-hmm.
you know.
But in that case, there's not going to be a two-way going back and forth regarding that.
No. It's usually people have questions.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Questions, they'll answer their questions, but they're not, you know, someone says, I'm not voting for this, I don't support this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. You know, say that, move away from the mic, and
exactly.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say thank you. One important thing, if you haven't been to a town meeting, you will, if you have or haven't been, everybody needs to give their name and address.
When they approach the microphone.
When they approach the microphone, name
okay.
and address.
Much like a select board meeting.
Absolutely.
Up in Westfield, you
Even
know,
if
go to
I,
council, you give your name
if,
and address.
If my daughter wants to stand up and say something as a registered voter, she needs mm-hmm. to tell me her name and address.
Mm-hmm.
So every person, no matter what, regardless.
All right. I've got 2 minutes left. Anything else you want to get out?
I encourage people to attend any special or town meeting. Mm-hmm. This is your opportunity to hear what's going on in your community,
mm-hmm.
and if you have an issue, this is the time to bring it up.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's great if you're a Monday morning quarterback. That's all well and good, but decisions have to be made. This is your opportunity to see why a decision was made the way it was.
Mm-hmm.
And we're a town. I would hope once a decision is made, people would respect that, and let's move forward.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we've had some nitpicking going on far too long. It's mm-hmm. time to remember that we're one community. We need positive thing in the press, the people that do still read the newspaper.
Mm-hmm.
We don't need some of the nonsense.
All right.
We're human. I know I called one of the select board members the wrong name last year.
Mm-hmm.
I may call someone the wrong name this year. I've been doing this for two. This is only my second town meeting. The person before me did it for 27 years. So
right.
For me, it's still a learning process.
Mm-hmm.
I may need to have a question for the lawyer, and I'll take a break and ask a question if I need to.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're human.
As you should. And for those who can't make it but want to watch it, I will be broadcasting and streaming the meeting. Now, it's not going to be like a Zoom thing. It's not going to be both ways, but you're going to be able to watch. And you're going to be able to watch it live on the Southwick Community Television YouTube page. You're going to be able to watch it live on Channel 15 if you're a Comcast subscriber. And if you're not a Comcast subscriber but you want to watch it via Channel 15, you can always go to the town website, southwickma.org, go to Channel 15 department and click on Watch Channel 15, and you'll be able to see the meeting that way. I will also be archiving it and posting it permanently so that it can always be gone back and viewed. And I will also be putting it into rotation on the Channel 15 schedule for the following month or so afterwards.
We're great to have you, Ken. Ken has been working with Ken has been absolutely amazing. He's a breath of fresh air.
I have a little bit of help from the great city from the north of you, yes. and Peter Coles with the community programming.
They
there.
Did a great job with our parade, so we were really happy to have them on board for that.
That was my big. That was my first big thing down there.
That was awesome. We had a great time.
Yeah. Pete said, "I'll give you the equipment. I'll help you out, but you're just going to drive it. You're gonna figure it out." And
I had so
and
much
it worked
fun.
Out.
I was hoping we could do that every year.
I'm not. I'm not above doing something like that.
We had fun.
Once
that
I get awesome. Additional gear, I hope to cover additional Southwick events at some point in time. And again, we can always work back and forth with Westfield. We have a good working relationship, and we'll figure it out. We'll get more
great.
Programming on the air.
Sounds great.
Good.
All right, Russ Celeste, I want to thank you for coming in.
Well, thank you, Ken.
All right, that's all I got.